the red and yellow bell pepper. There you go.
Known as the queen of Creole cuisine, Leah Chase made her mark feeding people, and she did it like few others have.
You know, that kitchen to me is my life.
Over the years, she's hosted presidents, actors, athletes, and civil rights icons. Her restaurant, after all, Dookie Chase, on Orleans Avenue in Treme, is a place of huge historical significance. During the civil rights era, Dookie Chase was one of the few places where mixed race groups would meet.
I was proud to feed them, but it was sad that they had no choices to go where they wanted to go.
The integration planning meetings, many of which Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. attended, were illegal at the time, but they went on anyway, and no one was gonna mess with Dookie Chase.
Some people think it was just about sitting at a counter next to a white person. That really wasn't their move, you know? It was to open doors, to get black people to vote, to get them educated.
Leah Chase, the oldest of 14 children, was born in Madisonville and moved to New Orleans when she was 14. She went from St. Mary's Academy to working at a restaurant in the French Quarter to marriage. In 1946, Leah Lang married Edgar Dookie Chase. The restaurant, which opened in 1941, evolved under Leah Chase from a sandwich shop to a charming Creole restaurant that embraces the African-American cultural environment. The restaurant's dining rooms feature artwork from world-renowned artists to new artists. A staunch proponent of the arts, Chase even testified before Congress to lobby for greater funding for the National Endowment for the Arts. She also served on the board of the New Orleans Museum of Art. In 2018, Leah Chase's 95th birthday was celebrated with a big bash. Never one for the spotlight, she still relished the moment with about 1,000 of her closest friends.
You know, I'm not one for a lot of hullabaloo, as I call all of this, but my kids and my grandchildren, they put all this together, and I'm forever grateful.
The self-taught cook who didn't measure ingredients authored 3 cookbooks and dazzled with her legendary recipes. The animated Disney film, The Princess and the Frog, was heavily influenced by New Orleans and was set in the Crescent City. One of the film's directors said Princess Tiana was greatly inspired by Leah Chase. Hurricane Katrina forced the closure of Dookie Chase for 2 years, but like much of New Orleans, it came back. The area rallied with a series of fundraisers, and Dookie Chase was back open in 2007. Leah Chase's awards and honors over the years are too numerous to mention, but the big ones include a Lifetime Achievement Award in 2000, the Times-Picayune's Loving Cup in 1997, the Leah Chase Louisiana Gallery at the Southern Food and Beverage Museum in 2009, and in 2010, the James Beard Foundation's Who's Who of Food and Beverage in America. In 2013, Leah Chase and her husband Edgar were named Grand Marshals of Zulu. Leah Chase left her mark on New Orleans and beyond. At the Smithsonian National Portrait Gallery, hers was the first chef's portrait in the permanent collection. The queen of Creole cuisine may be gone, but her legend and influence will live on through her mantra, work hard and enjoy every day.
Get up in the morning and don't complain. Look around you. Look at the trees, look at the birds, look at life, and just enjoy that day. And have faith, for heaven's sakes.